When you create something, most times you try to make it good. If you are a perfectionist, such as myself, you try to make each project the best thing you've ever done. This can be a good thing. It makes you push yourself to improve your skills, and you get better at your craft. However, this mindset can be not so good for you in the long run.
I strongly believe that finishing things is a habit that you need to work on, a skill that you need to practice. When you make lots of little pieces of creative work, when you write or record lots of little bits and pieces of songs, or whatever creative thing you do, that over time becomes the very thing you do. You get used to making little chord progressions or bits of melodies or riffs or parts of riffs or half bass lines or whatever. But you're not actually writing songs. You're not a songwriter.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Monday Show. My name is Nice Peter. I'm glad that you're here.
This is Nice Peter. This man is one of my favorite creators in the history of YouTube. He's one of the original creators of the epic rap battles of history. When I was 15 years old, I was a big fan of the rap battles, but I was a bigger fan of his personal channel. He used to make this thing called The Monday Show. I remember in one of the videos, he was talking about songwriting and creativity, and I will never forget one of the videos. I couldn't find the exact one because there are so many of them, but there was one video where he talked about writing a bad song and making it bad on purpose.
I talk about this sometimes in songwriting, where sometimes you need to write a bad song on purpose to be writing songs. Mm-hmm. Like, instead of worrying, oh, is this song going to be good enough? Just write it. Make it bad on purpose. Write a bad song just so you start that process flowing.
So, I'm about to start making a bad song. The point here is making it bad and finishing it. So, I'm gonna try to make it in under an hour, although I'm not sure if I'm able to finish a track in just 1 hour. I've never tried it, but let's see. I'm gonna try to make it as simple as possible, so I'm probably not gonna be dubbing guitars. I really don't have a plan. But let's see what happens. Okay, 1 hour, here we go. Now, I'm not saying that you should spend all of your time writing bad songs. This is just an exercise, an experiment, if you will. The thing is that as creators, we need to get comfortable with failing a lot. Me as a songwriter, I need to get comfortable with writing bad songs. If you want to start writing music, you need to get comfortable with the idea that your first song is probably gonna be really bad. And that's okay. We need to embrace failure and have a healthy relationship with it.
Love this one. Fail early, fail often, fail forward. You know, it's always a little bit frustrating to me when people have a negative relationship with failure. Failure is a massive part of being able to be successful. You have to get comfortable with failure. You have to actually seek failure. Failure is where all of the lessons are.
This is Will Smith. You know who Will Smith is. He has these really cool Instagram stories about failure. You can check it out on his Instagram. I think it's on YouTube also. Just Google Will Smith failure. I think it's life-changing. Really, check it out.
Failure actually helps you to recognize the areas where you need to evolve. So fail early, fail often, fail forward.
You're gonna have to write like 1,000 bad songs, and I mean bad, before you get one good one. So you better start writing. First, I'm gonna make a beat. I can't even open Easy Drummer. Actually, I'm gonna start with the chord progression. Change of plans. Okay. I'm gonna try to only tune the guitar once. That's close enough. So I'm gonna come up with the chord progression before, because I feel like for me that's an easier way to come up with the tempo, and then I'm gonna track the drums using my MIDI keyboard. I need a new computer. Four chords. The one. That sounds weird. It's bad. Let's go with it. 1 7, then the 4, and then the 5, and then 1. Okay, so let's just do 1, and then 1 with a 7th, 4, and then 5, because that first version was a little too bad. Okay, I'm overthinking. Okay, what is my tempo? Dun, 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 dun. Like 117? Okay, that's good. Okay, that's the intro. Now, drums. 1, 2, 3, 4. I've had this weird problem for a while. Sometimes I have this idea for a song or a video or a concept for an album and I think, oh, that's good, but I shouldn't do it right now because I need a bigger audience. I need more people to see this because it's like a really good idea and I don't wanna waste it.
The problem is that the first time that you do something, it's gonna suck. So get it out quickly. Get the suck out. Do it. Get the brain crack out of your head and just start doing the thing because the first three are gonna stink, right? And that is the sort of real realization of the creative process is trusting that you're gonna have more great ideas and that through the process of getting the work out of your body and into the real world is the real challenge of any sort of creative life.
This video was one of the things that made me realize that this way of thinking displays a really big lack of confidence. You need to trust that your brain will be able to come up with good ideas until you die. If you just sit on your ideas, you are wasting them. I say, f*** it. Use all your good ideas now. You will come up with better ones. I'm gonna use the chord progression from the intro in the chorus. And then I'm going to use a different one for the verse. I'm getting caught up in trying to make it good. That's the trickiest part right now. Oh, I'm not tracking.
Hey!
Why am I not? Okay, I have a verse. I'm going to add a low pass filter to the guitar. I'm going to copy and paste the verse. So I have intro, verse, chorus. I'm going to have a bridge. Chorus again. I'm gonna make the intro a little shorter. I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to do this in just 1 hour. Now we need a bridge. So let's go to A minor for the bridge.
Greetings one and all, this is Guthrie Govan here.
Guthrie Govan is one of the best guitar players in the world right now. In his book, Creative Guitar 1, he says,
"Finish things. Successfully writing one whole tune will be more beneficial to your musicianship than writing 20 small chord progressions and never bothering to link them together. One of the key factors in a really effective bit of music is its structure, the way in which different sections fit together, and the calculated use of devices like repetition, 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 and the surprise factor. Once you start thinking about these issues, you'll find yourself listening to other people's music with a slightly different agenda." Yeah, it's time for bass. Didn't even check my input levels, holy crap.
No, my bass is not working.
Oh my god, I'm so stupid. I can't figure out my own chord progression. I'm gonna add R bass. You see what my problem is? I'm not even done tracking and I'm already mixing. Do you ever do that? Do you start mixing while you're tracking? Let's add a second guitar. I'm gonna try to do the whole thing in one take. Fuck.
Hey!
I'm actually trying to make it decent. Now I'm doing some very, very minimal mixing. Oh no, my computer is crashing. And time. Okay, I still have 19 minutes left, so it took about 41 minutes. I would say it's bad. I definitely started trying to make it good at some point. I finished it. It's done. It's kind of a song. It's a full instrumental. I wasn't planning on adding any vocals anyways, and my battery's dying. I did it. You guys wanna hear it? Let's listen to my bad song that I made in under 45 minutes.